Hello friends, welcome back to next one. In this session we are going to discuss validation part of the post request. So before moving that, what we are going to do in this post request, we have used random string method or random number method. So we are going to generate data on the fly. So what we can do instead, let's say we are automating 10 requests, so we have to write the same line again and again. So to do that in better way, what we are going to do, we are creating one more class for Java util. So wherever in our framework we are going to use Java code, we are going to put in this utils. This is my Java utils. So what I am going to do, I am going to generate some static method here, public static int random number. I need random number in integer format. So I am going to generate random number here, and this method is going to return me a random number. So but in all the entire framework we are going number as a string value, so we need to return as a string value. So we have to generate the number and we have to cast it into a string value. So in last session we have learned how to generate a random number. So we have to run same code there. So I am simply copying and I am pasting here. So this is going to give me a random number and it is going to create up to 100. So we are changing it to 1000 value and we need to return the string value. Return ID. So it will return me a number in a string format. Now we need to create one more utility for generating random string value. Random string. And same logic we have to copy paste here. So this is the same line. Java utils. This line we are going to create up to 8 digits. And we have to return the value as well. So return random string. So this is going to return me a random string. My post request, I can simply call that method. So first I have to create an object of that class, java utils, and I need to access this method. So instead of using these lines, I can remove this and I can simply use these values here. So ID I need to get using this utils. So utils dot random number, and for author and other thing we need to get random string. Utils dot random string. Utils dot random string. Now the thing is, we are getting here warning. So warning, it is saying we have created static method, but even though we have created the object for that. So instead of going with this, you can also do this, but simply what we can do, instead of we can use that method with class reference. So this is again Java concept. So if you are creating a framework, you should know each and every concept in detail. So why we are going with static method, how we can use static method, so these things we need to learn. So like this I can do. Now the thing is, let me hit the post request. So if I'm going to hit post request, let me change the ID. So I'm getting response as a JSON object, but for get request I'm getting response as a JSON array. So we have created utility to validate response from JSON array, but we haven't created to validate for JSON object. So what we can do, we can add one more method here. So this we have added response key validation from array. This method we are going to update, and we are going to create one more method, public static void response key validation from JSON object, and we need to pass two parameters. One is response as a response and another is value. So I have to pass string and key. So in this case, what I have to do, I have to use as a JSON object. So I am getting data as a JSON object. So again, I am writing my code in a try catch block, and I'll get data as a JSON object. So JSON object, JSON is equal to new JSON object, and I have to pass a response as a string here. So response dot get body dot a string. A string is a Groovy syntax. I'm going to check my value is contains in a response or not. So how can I do? JSON dot has. So there is one method which is JSON dot has. So whatever key I'm passing, first I'm checking that response contains that particular value or not. If it is contains, then I'm going to assert the data. So first I'll check response dot has key, and one more thing I'm going to check, key should not be null. So whatever value we have created, it is actually updated in server or not. So we are going to check that, because this is going to check key is there, and now we are going to check our value is there or not. So JSON dot get key, my key, and it should not is equal to null. So if we are satisfying with these two requirements, then we are going to log the my status. Status dot log, log status dot pass, and we have to write some valid message here. So successfully validate the value, validated value of my key. Successfully we have validated value of key, and I'm going to add meaningful message. It is value is, so this is my key, what I want to validate. So I'm going to validate my key, and my value is JSON dot get key. So this is done. Now I have to add a failure message as well. So if I'm not able to find this particular value, then what I'm going to do, in else state JSON dot log, and it should be fail. So my key is not available, and if this method won't work, then we are going to log as a stack trace. So let me run my request again. Let me go to the post request, and now API dot API verification dot random key validation from array and response key validation as a JSON object. So we are receiving JSON object, we are getting JSON object. So object, and I am going to validate my value. So my value, which is let's say I am going to validate title. So I have to pass key as a title in a string value. And one more thing is API verification dot response code validation, and status code is 201, and response time verification. So API dot response time validation, and I have to pass the response. And before starting my test, I am writing test dot log, log status dot info, and my test is starting. My test is starting. End of the test, my test has been ended. So now let me run it. Arguments, so everything is correct. We need to run this test. The test is completed. Now I should get a report. So let me refresh the project. Need to go to test output. Inside report, inside test folder, we will get HTML report. So let me go to the particular folder and open it with browser. So here our report is generated, valid API, post API test, successfully validated the value of title, and it is this. Status code 201 and API response time is 500. So this is how end-to-end flow works. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching the video.